Hey guys, and welcome to my hurricane forecast. In this forecast, I'm going to be talking about tropical storm Pamela that's going to undergo rapid intensification. Then it's going to move into Texas. So as of the latest National Hurricane Center key message on this system, it says that Pamela is forecast to be near major hurricane intensity when it reaches the southwestern coast of Mexico by Wednesday morning, and life-threatening storm surge and dangerous hurricane force winds are expected within the hurricane warning area. Residents in this area should follow advice given by local officials. Pamela is expected to pass to the south of southern tip of Baja California Peninsula as a hurricane on Tuesday and Tuesday night, and tropical storm conditions are possible within that area that has a tropical storm watch. So if you live in that area, you should be expecting tropical storm conditions. That's where there's a tropical storm watch. So then it says that heavy rains associated with Pamela is forecast expected to move into Mexican states such as Sinaloa and western Durango, along with southern portions of Baja California, Sir Tuesday and Wednesday. This will pose a flooding threat and of significant life-threatening mudslides and flash flooding, and also mudslides. Heavy rain associated with the remnants of Pamela is forecast to move across portions of central Texas and southeastern Oklahoma late Wednesday and Thursday. This may result in flash and new brown flooding. So guys, if you live in areas like Baja California, you should expect very dangerous tropical storm conditions, hence why there's tropical storm watches up for that area, and that might be replaced with tropical storm warnings extremely soon. So also, if you live in portions of Sinaloa, Mexico, you should be expecting hurricane conditions, as that's the direct area that I expect the storm to make a direct landfall on. As you could see, that my previous prediction went extremely correct when it came to this storm. So guys, you guys should pay attention to this if you live in portions of Sinaloa, Mexico, and also western Durango, Mexico. So guys, you should expect dangerous weather conditions. There's going to be storm surge, there's going to be wind, there's going to be significant damages and threats that this storm is going to be bringing with it as it's going to be moving inland. So guys, the remnants is going to be traveling towards Texas and also portions of Oklahoma. So guys, if you live in Texas and Oklahoma, guys, you should be expecting a tropical depression, guys, as this system moves inland. So the good part about this system is it's not expected to emerge back out into the Gulf of Mexico, but rather make a landfall on Texas as just a post-tropical depression that's going to be bringing severe weather with it, and also the potential for tornadoes. So guys, we're going to keep you guys posted with that. Now we're going to head over towards forecast models on this system. So guys, as of the latest GFS model run, you can see here is our tropical system just to the southwest of Baja California, and you can see the system is down to 982 millibar, maybe a category 2 hurricane at this point. And you can see that the system is organized at this point. Very heavy rainfalls focused around the center of circulation. So guys, this is a very organized system at this time. So this system is going to continue on this track as it continues to move towards the northeast. So now we're going to continue to run this model. So the farther we get out into the model, we see that this system continues to move over portions of Durango, Mexico, and you can see that this system continues to move towards the northeast, getting closer towards Texas. So at this time, when the system makes a landfall on portions of Sinaloa, Mexico, there's definitely going to be dangerous weather conditions such as storm surge and also damaging wind impacts. And also there's going to be extremely dangerous weather conditions. So as we continue to run the model, we see this system travel over portions of Mexico. And you can see that as this storm system gets close to Texas, the system gets elongated. But you can see that this could be bringing the severe weather threat, such as very strong winds and also the threat for some tornadoes that this system could spawn while moving through as a tropical depression. So guys, this could be a threat from this system as it's going to be moving through. So guys, you should pay close attention to this if you live in Texas, because they could also be bringing very severe weather and also potential for tornadoes and also the potential for very damaging winds and also the potential for flooding. So those are the impacts that you're going to be expecting from this system if you live in portions of Texas. And as we continue to run the model, we see that this system moves into portions of Kansas, and you can see this continues on its northeastern track. So guys, the track that we're expecting of this system is for this system to take this direct track and head towards the northeast and affect portions of Texas and Oklahoma. But first it will affect portions of Sinaloa, Mexico, then it's going to continue on that track towards the north, towards the northeast as it continues to progress. So guys, we're going to continue to watch this system because there's going to be a very significant severe weather threat that it's going to be bringing, particularly if you live in portions of Texas. And if you live in portions of Mexico, you should expect very dangerous weather conditions such as storm surge, wind, and also very significant flood threats from this system. So guys, I'm going to keep you guys posted and updated on this system. So as always, peace out, and thank you guys for watching this video. So thank you guys so much for 300 subscribers, and we're going to continue to grow. So thank you guys for watching.